from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from three donors. The first is Francine Morrison of Waterloo, Ontario, for her late husband, Vincent Morrison, and dad to their daughter, Bernadette, who is celebrating her birthday today on August the 12th with her mother and brother, Tony Morrison, at their family home in Waterloo. The second is an anonymous donor from Mississauga, Ontario, for the living and deceased members of their family, for their good health, and for the return of family members to the church, for the souls in purgatory who have no one to pray for them, and for the end to the pandemic. The third is John from Markham, Ontario, in loving memory of his beloved wife, Agnes Mon-Jin, on her second death anniversary today. His aunt Lang Ying and eldest sister Mary Jo Koo, and for the living and deceased members of the Yu, Chen, and Koo families. Also, continued blessings for all parishioners of St. Thomas the Apostle Parish and the Daily TV Mass viewers, or thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like Jane Frances de Chantal did about 400 years ago, knowing that she was weak, knowing that she needed God's guidance at every breath she took. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, who made Jane Frances de Chantal radiant with outstanding merits in different walks of life, grant us, through her intercession, that walking faithfully in our vocation, we may constantly be examples of shining light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people and said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children, and talk about them when you are at home, and when you are away, when you lie down, and when you rise. Bind them as a sign on your hand. Fix them as an emblem on your forehead. And write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. When the Lord your God has brought you into the land that he swore to your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give you, a land with fine, large cities that you did not build, houses filled with all sorts of goods that you did not fill, hewn cisterns that you did not hew, vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. And when you have eaten your fill, take care that you do not forget the Lord, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. The Lord your God you shall fear. Him you shall serve, and by his name alone you shall swear." The word of the Lord.
My God. Lord, my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the source of my salvation, my stronghold. I love you, Lord, my strength. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, so I shall be saved from my enemies. From his temple he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears. I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord lives, blessed be my rock, and exalted be the God of my salvation. Great triumphs he gives to his King, and shows steadfast love to his anointed. I love you, Lord, my strength. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Jesus Christ has done away with death and brought us life through the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After the transfiguration, Jesus with Peter, James, and John came down from the mountain. When they came to the crowds, a man came to Jesus, knelt before him, and said, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is an epileptic, and he is suffering terribly. He often falls into the fire and often into the water. And I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him. Jesus answered, You faithful, faithless, and perverse generation, how much longer must I be with you? How much longer must I put up with you? Bring him here to me. And Jesus rebuked the demon, and it came out of him, and the boy was cured instantly. Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, Why could we not cast it out? Jesus said to them, Because of your little faith. For truly I tell you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, Move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I think Jesus is having a bad day. It feels a little bit like I can go on a retreat and I have this beautiful silence. And then, so Jesus comes back from the mountain, from the transfiguration, and it can be heavenly, and then after I've been a day back in my office, it feels like it was 2 months ago, because the drama of every day hits you again. And Jesus, the same, he comes down from the mountain and the drama of every day hits him again. And and so he lashes out in a sense, or he's becoming sarcastic. You people of little faith. And it is true, we are people of little faith. And it became very clear to me again, I was reminded of this just a few days ago. We have one of our brothers, Jesuit brothers, brother Paul, who had worked for 40 years in Zambia in agriculture to bring agriculture good agriculture practices to Africa, and he's dying in our community of a brain tumor. And after I gave him the viaticum, the last sacrament, he says to me, I'm really don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what's going to happen. A man of faith and good prayer life, but he says, I don't know what's happening. And of course, I said, I cannot tell you either. I haven't been there yet, so we'll find out. But it is something we have to discover. That's why we walk by faith, not by sight. We just have to trust. And really, those are the words of to me, to Brother Paul too. Keep trusting, all will be well. And we can have these glimpses of the afterlife. We know there is an afterlife, but how it looks, I have no idea, haven't been there yet. But I will get my turn, no doubt. But because we're people of little faith, we have to be reminded of this all the time. And Moses, in Deuteronomy, it's this long speech of Moses. He's reminding the Israelites, and he teaches them the Shema. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord, your God, with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. And the Jewish people are asked to do this twice a day, morning and evening, just to remind themselves that God is real, that God is with us, and that God will look after us. Of course, as Catholics, we don't say the Shema anymore, but we say the Our Father, which is actually very much, again, recognizing that God is first, but it's more like a covenant. God looks after us, and we have to do our part. We trust God, but we also have to be a people who are forgiving and looking out for others around us. And this is part, of course, of our story, to be there for others. And no doubt, also today is Our Lady's Saturday, but I chose to do the Mass for Jane Frances de Chantal. But Our Lady, Mother of God, of course, did the same thing. She prayed the Shema at least twice a day, reminding herself that God is first before everything. And so this is, of course, our journey, that we have to remind ourselves always too. And that's why we say the Our Father so often, reminding that God is reminding ourselves that God is first. And of course, as I just said, today we celebrate the optional Saint Jane Frances de Chantal, and who was born in 1572, lived to 1645. She was a young woman, got married, had a good marriage. Some of her children died. She became a foster mother to her sister's children, and her husband died in a hunting accident. And she, when she came out of her depression after the great loss and meeting St. Francis de Sales, St. Francis de Sales, who was such an inspiration in that time, who became her spiritual director, and helped her to start the Visitation of the Holy Mary, the Order of the Visitation of Holy Mary, also known as Salesian Sisters, not to be confused with the Salesian Sisters of Don Bosco. But it was about the visitations, reminding them how Mary visited Elizabeth in her pregnancy. And so this order, they saw a need in their time, just like in our time, so many people lonely and suffering by themselves, that they needed visitations, that people would come and visit them, bring them communion, and help them out, maybe with some light chores and so and whatsoever. And it was very radical for that time to set up a religious community who were not cloistered, and who were not bound by basically the bell ringing every 15 minutes for something else. But people, mainly women and widows, who were living at home, but who went out together and visited the sick and helped out. and something they recognized in their own contemporary culture. And no doubt, when Jane Frances, when she came out of her depression after all her losses in her life, she would have come across Psalm 18, and maybe St. Francis Sales would have pointed it out. I love you, Lord, my strength. And that is the responsory psalm. But it's the responsory for a psalm. But it's a psalm of trust. A God who always comes to our rescue. Although we're people of little faith, a God who is always there and trying to bring good out of bad, and who will lead us through the ups and downs of life, just like God led Jane Frances de Chantal through her life of struggles and so on, always trying to bring good out of it. And we know that the Order of the Visitations, they've done good work, and they continue to do good work across the world. Amen. So let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in our daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for families, for peace in times of blessings and difficulty, protection for children, and respect for the elderly and vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray that the World Youth Day in Lisbon will help young people to live and witness to the gospel in their own lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all who are struggling with their faith, that hearts will be opened to the good news of Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
With
humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may your sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Most merciful God, who were pleased to create in Blessed Jane Frances the new person in your image, the old of having passed away, graciously grant, we pray, that renewed like her, we may offer you the acceptable sacrifice of conciliation through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to the experience on this earth, the gift you promise in the new world to come. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these guests, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Take away the sins.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. By the power of the sacrament, Lord, we pray, lead us always in your love through the example of Blessed Jane Frances de Chantal, and bring to the fulfillment the good work you have begun in us until the day of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.